can recycle part of its own content by sequestering a portion of the cytoplasm in a double membrane vesicle that is delivered to the lysosome for degradation. Do you know what is lysosome? Lysosome is a cell organelle where all the garbages are destroyed and damaged. But before throwing them to the central garbage system, lysosome is a central garbage system of the cell, garbage recycling system of the cell. Autophagy is another process of recycling, because some of the cellular materials, they are not useful, but they can be recycled to make new products. So autophagy is like that. Early history, let us tell you briefly about the early history of autophagy. Belgian scientist Christian de Bouve was interested in action of insulin. He studied intercellular localization of glucose 6 phosphatase using cell fractionation method. You know insulin, what is the function of insulin? Insulin is a very famous hormone involved in metabolism of the glucose. And he studied action of insulin, how it works with the glucose 6 phosphatase enter. And Dubé observed a new specialized cellular compartment or component in the cell called an organelle containing enzymes that digest proteins, carbohydrates and lipids, which is called lysosome. Lysosome, what can do? Lysosome can digest protein, carbohydrate and lipids which are not necessary for the cell. Okay? Cell prepare lots of materials. Like in our house, all the materials are not used. Some of them are waste. So, lysosome function as a workstation for the degradation of cellular constituents. Unnecessary cellular constituents which are useless, that you can say waste. 1960s to 70s, Dubé first coined. Coined means he first termed this term autophagy. Autophagy in 1963 and extensively discussed the concept in a review article published a few years later. Christian Dubé awarded Nobel Prize in Physiology or Medicine in 1974 for the discovery of lysosome. He discovered lysosome with Albert Claudel. And autophagy, a lysosome-mediated intracellular degradation pathway, was discovered in late 50s means, nearly 60. And cell biologists exploring the mammalian cell with the newly developed high-resolution transmission electron microscopy. Autophagy, very small structure. So normal microscope, you cannot clearly study how autophagy mechanism is going on. So early scientists started to use transmission electron microscopy. Do you know what is the difference between scanning electron microscopy and transmission electron microscopy? Any idea? Scanning electron microscopy, we use to observe the upper surface of the any object, how it looks like, surface morphology. But transmission electron microscopy, we want to see the internal spaces by making the cross section, like we make section for the histological study. So for transmission electron microscopy, we need diamond knife to make section, and we can see what is going inside the cell, okay, inside the any object. So, transmission electron microscopy technique was first used to observe the cell lysosome-like membrane-bound structure contained organelle-like mitochondria. Very interesting. It is a double membrane-bound structure. Autophagy, at that time, people had no clear idea what is it. Later, those structures were called cytolysosomes, not only autophagosomes. They were called cytolysosomes because they present in the cytosol. And next to auto, and later, scientists named them autophagosomes. Autophagosomes means special structure which wrap up the waste product in the cell. And in 1963, the term autophagy was coined by the Christian Dubé, already I mentioned. At that time, it was impossible to imagine how broad and significant the influence of autophagy, because our understanding about the cell biological component were very limited, and microscopic technique was not too much advanced. And autophagy is today recognized as a major quality control pathway and metabolic regulation system in the cell. What is the major role of autophagy? And it is a quality control pathway and metabolic regulatory system in the cell. And in essence, autophagy proceeds when the selected part of the cytosol is engulfed. Selected part of the cytosol. You know cytosol? Outside all the cellular components in the cell, semi-liquid substances are there, it is called cytosol. And all the, cell organelles present in the cytosol. So, autophagy proceed when a selected part of the cytosol is engulfed. Engulfed means to wrap up by a double membrane forming a structure called autophagosome, which later fuses to the lysosome, digestive organelle of the cell, where a number of catabolic enzymes are used. You may ask me, who are regulating the autophagosome and autophagic process? Lots of genes have been discovered. You know what it is and what is the DNA. And Yoshinori Ohsumi, this scientist worked not on humans, he worked on yeast. Have you heard about yeast? Can you name an yeast? Any yeast, can you name an yeast? Scientific name of an yeast, which is a, model organism, model fungus? E. coli is not a yeast. E. coli is not a fungi, E. coli is a bacteria. So, if I ask you a model fungus, what would be the name? And model yeast, which? Anyone? Saccharomyces cerevisiae is a yeast, which is a model organism. I told you in the previous lecture in the genome editing. So, yeast cells are relatively easy to study. And they are eukaryote. We are human are eukaryote. Consequently, they are often used as a model for human because eukaryotic cell, yeast cell, and human cell are structurally and functionally very close. And this is why scientists use the single cellular, yeast cell, particularly useful for identification of genes that are important for complex cellular pathways. So instead of human, people use the yeast as an object for studying the eukaryotic pathway. In early 90s, almost 30 years after De Dubé coined the term autophagy, De Dubé coined the term autophagy in 1973 or 74, and 1990s, 30 years later, the process remained a biological enigma. It was a mystery. And 30 years, from 70 to 90, scientists didn't study too much and didn't discover much about the autophagy. Molecular markers were not available at that time, and components of the autophagy machinery were elusive. Do you know what is elusive? That is a mystery and not known, but many fundamental questions remain to be answered. How was the autophagy process initiated? Then the question was, how was the autophagosome formed, the special structure? And the question was, how important was autophagy for cellular and organism survival? Is it essential or is it important for the cell? And did autophagy have any role in human disease? That was the most important important because we humans always consider whether any biological process related to our health or not. So autophagosis is related to our cell or not, it was another question. Although biochemical and morphological phenomena of autophagy fascinated the cell biology, nothing is known about the underlying molecular mechanism, how autophagosis is formed, how autophagy recycles the cellular materials, it was almost unknown. And Osumi, Yoshinori Osumi, the famous guy, bearded man, he approached this problem by studying autophagy in yeast. He studied in yeast, and in which lysosome-like vacuoles are endpoint and the autophagy pathway. Autophagy pathway he started to study. In the early 1980s, he discovered by cell biologists working in the model system, Saccharomyces cerevisiae. What is the model fungus? Saccharomyces cerevisiae. Saccharomyces cerevisiae is a model fungus. It is yeast. And industrially, biotechnology has been used to use yeast since ancient times. For which purpose? Yeast has been used. For bakery. Yes, baking industry, you know, yeast, even in the market, it is available. So yeast is, an old biotechnology. Osumi identified autophagy body in nitrogen-deprived yeast cell. What he did? Yeast cell, living yeast, he deprived, he didn't offer nitrogen-containing materials to the yeast so that they are deprived from the yeast. When you are fasting in the Ramadan, your body also deprived from food. Nitrogen, you cannot eat meat, you cannot eat milk, you cannot eat egg. At that time, interestingly, during fasting, autophagy is more functional than the non-fasting period. So, Osumi identified autophagy body. In nitrogen-deprived yeast cerevisiae was the first report that nutrient deficiency induced autophagy degradation in yeast. When you are fasting, how you get the energy? How your cell get the protein? How your cell get the carbohydrate? Because during fasting, your body also growing. How did it happen? Do you have any idea? Yes, stored food in your muscle protein or lipid proteins, they are breakdown. How? Through the process of autophagy. So autophagy is very important during we are fasting, and they become very active and recycle the stored food into useful nutrients so that you can grow up, you can get the energy, you can move, you can work. So Osumi, a key point of his approach was the use of vacuolar protease inhibitors to allow the accumulation of intermediate autophagy bodies, the inner membrane bound content in the double membrane autophagosome inside the vacuole. He used different approaches to understand the double membrane bound autophagosome, how they are formed, how they are regulated, and how they work in the cell. Osumi's lab characterized this structure by using transmission electron microscopy. So Yoshinori Osumi used transmission electron microscopy to make lots of sections to see in different time intervals how autophagosomes are formed and grow up and how it works. Clear? He used a transmission electron microscope, and he also developed mutant. Do you know what is mutant? Mutant, for example, mutant, same organism, yeast cerevisiae, but which is lacking certain genes for autophagy process. So he found mutant, which is unable to proceed for the autophagy. So, and then he did to be for normal cell as well as the mutant to see what is the difference. Because mutant, which has no capacity, no gene for autophagic process, and then you can easily compare the mutant isolated by originally called APC, autophagy. And FPC1 mutant were identified by their defect in accumulation of autophagy bodies. Oh, that means FPC1 was a mutant which has defect, cannot accumulate the autophagy body, that means cannot accumulate waste product to process and recycle. So it was very nice to compare with the normal cell as well as the mutant. And with this groundbreaking work using mutants, Hoshmi's lab identified first autophagy gene. His lab first discovered the first autophagy gene, because when he compared the mutant as well as the normal cell, he found that mutant contains lacking of one gene, and that gene is involved in autophagy because mutant cannot perform the autophagy. And it was the big discovery, because once you discover a gene, then you can transfer it others and you can do lots of study. This main paper you should republish in world famous journal that is autophagy in each double strain with proteinase deficient mutants and conditions for its induction. That big publication in 1992 actually was the big journey and big discovery, breakthrough for discovery of the mechanism of autophagy. And then lots of other papers published in Nature, receptor mediated selective autophagy. That means how autophagosome work, how signal is perceived. All the things were discovered later on, step by step. And also we faced several challenges to discover all the gene as well as the mechanism. These cells are small and their inner structure are not easily distinguished under the microscope. It was one of the big challenges for the usually also me. And he was uncertain whether autophagy even exists in the organism. Because he studied the yeast, he was not sure. Same thing happened in the other organism like human or in the plant. But finally, it was found that although he discovered first in yeast, it is equally and similarly happened in the other eukaryotic cell. Also, we overcome the challenge by step-by-step process. And finally, he made the breakthrough. This is very important, image for your examination. And you can understand, first, when autophagosome how starts and how ends, there is the pathway. First, double membrane structure nucleation is started. You see, a double membrane structure, like a polythene bag, you put the thing. So first starting point is this, autophagosome double membrane structure. And then, that structure, pull all the unnecessary materials in the cell. Cell contains unnecessary materials. For example, if you take antibiotic kills the pathogen, but where antibiotic goes? Antibiotic remains in the cell, and that antibiotic needs to digest by using autophagy. And when a gene expression takes place, for example, when you are very excited or when you are chilled with the cold temperature, specific gene expression takes place. At that time, new proteins are generated, but when you become normal, no cold chilling environment or no excitement, where the exciting proteins go? All the proteins go to the autophagosome. You see all the things, even unnecessary mitochondria or some cell inactive, your cellular materials inactive, no need to use in the cell. All are coming to this part. And finally, you see, they are wrapped up. You put all the garbage in a polythene bag and then wrap up the materials. It is wrapped up. After wrapping up, what it does, You know, lots of enzymes are involved to make chopping and digest them for recycling. You see? And finally, after recycling, some materials coming back to the cell for reuse. And some and others, you know, mixed with the lysosome. They merge together. So lysosome and autophagosome mix together. And finally, those are useless. They're totally done and excreted from the body. Is it clear, this mechanism of autophagy? And it will be in your exam. So please go through. This is the main learning point in this course. And now the question is, why autophagy is important? You can imagine, if you in your house or in our university, if there is no garbage cleaning system, what would happen? The university will be a garbage, your house will be a garbage. So every day it needs to be cleaning. So autophagy, clean, always clean ourselves. This is number one. Number two, it is the smartest recycling system. So recycle unnecessary materials and make them useful. So this is why it is very important for metabolic homeostasis, that is metabolic balance, regulation of vital processes, and obviously guardian of cellular integrity and integrity. And deregulation, if somehow your autophagy process disturbed or disrupted, what would happen? You will be aged quickly. You will be older quickly. You will have different problems, for example, disease, different diseases, because within the garbage, in the cell, all the toxic materials, unnecessary materials, if they are not clean, then cancer can be developed, metabolic disorder can be developed, aging process will be accelerated, different infection can be taken place, inflammation would be a big problem, neurodegeneration would be taken place. So these are the processes will be taken place if autophagic process is somehow disturbed. And during your fasting in Ramadan, autophagy process accelerates. As a result, people call that Ramadan is good for the health. If you visit in Europe, very interesting, in Europe, especially in Germany, if you go to Germany, German people take very little at the night. Very little, a small cake or biscuit or like that. And whole day they do the fasting. And whole night they do the fasting. And in the morning what they do? Breakfast. Breakfast. That means fasting, breaking of the fasting. So this is why German people, you see, they like longer time. Even Japanese people also, they take less food at night. So if you want to survive longer, what you need to do? At night you need to take less food. Less food at night. And the maximum food as much as possible in the morning. And breakfast, but unfortunately in your case, in most of the Bengali people, in the morning they take less. It is not good. Okay? And in Germany, they are clean during the breakfast. And they are like a young girl during the, lunch. And in the evening, they are the beggar. So this is the German style. This is why they can survive longer. And this is good for autophagy process. German people, they know very well what is autophagy possibility. So you can understand the consequences of autophagy. Any question? So autophagy, now you can ask a question. Whether autophagy is present in plant or not? Yes. Because plants also do senescence. And autophagic process, when plants become older, at that time, autophagic process lower. But young, seedling, autophagic process is very fast. So in the plastic degradation, in the senescence leaf, mature leaf, you can see yellowing and other color develop due to the autophagy. And in the plant, Osuji published several papers in plant physiology, but he got the Nobel Prize in medicine. So autophagy, this is the historical timeline how autophagy process is discovered. this is the autophagy discovered in the cancer cell. Cancer, now the question is, cancer cell, you question, you have to answer whether cancer cell has smarter autophagy than normal cell. What do you think? Which cell has smarter autophagy process, cancer or normal? Normal cell has poorer autophagy than the cancer cell. This is why cancer cell super sleep. And we are now trying to understand why cancer cell has smarter autophagy. And then this is why they capture, you know, a small cancer can kill you. All the other cells can be killed by the cancer cell because they have the smarter autophagy. And if we know the molecular mechanism of autophagy in the cancer cell, we can control that. So autophagy, I think in many organisms, autophagy has been discovered. These are the genes discovered for the autophagy pathway. Not a single gene. Lots of genes, autophagy, FEG1 from the first autophagy gene was discovered by autophagy. Later, many scientists, they discovered lots of other genes, they are involved in autophagy process. So, this is autophagy, why it is important for our health. And from autophagy, what we can learn? We can learn we have to keep clean our room, we have to keep clean our body, we have to keep clean our university, and it is the, and we have to follow the recycling process. This is the, you know, world trend now. How can we recycle the resources? And that would be the great thing. This is the, you know, Oshumin photograph autophagy structure. He studied lots of, you know, by using transmission electron microscopy, the autophagosomes. So my comment is, autophagy is very important and it is ubiquitous. Do you know what is ubiquitous? Means every square, all eukaryotic system, it is present. And it is a recycling process, garbage. It is a garbage recycling process. And if I ask you, write, illustrate the application of autophagy. Where application of autophagy can be used. For example, if you want to kill the cancer cell, you have to know the autophagy process of the cancer cell, then you can target it. And you can increase the innate immunity, immune system you can activate. Cardiomyopathy, aging, infectious disease, fatty liver is another big problem for many persons. And type 2 diabetes, neurodegenerative disease. And if we want to cure us from this type of diseases, we need to know the underlying molecular mechanism of autophagy more details. So these are the applications for autophagy. And autophagy has positive rule as well as negative rule. What are the positive rule? These are the positive rule. Survival during short-term starvation. Because if autophagy process is not present, we cannot do fasting. Autophagy process help us to do fasting. You can starve yourself, otherwise you will die. Your life engine, movement will be stopped. Defense against intracellular pathogens. You can defend themselves against the, you can defend yourself against the pathogen. And program cell death. Autophagy also has the program cell death, that is apoptosis. Longevity, you can survive longer time. And organelle turnover, protection against metabolic stress and DNA damage, clearance of aggregate proteins, regulation of cell size, all of the things are regulated by the autophagy process. Now the question is, yes, is there any negative role of autophagy? Yes, there are some negative role because cancer cells, they have super autophagy process. This is why it is a big problem for us. As well as reactive oxygen species, DNA damage, autophagic cell death, and induction of autophagy is a big problem. So promotion of cancer is due to the powerful autophagic process present in the cancer cell. But what human can do? Human has been trying to understand why cancer cells, in which pathway they are they have the powerful photophagy process. If we know that, then we can use them as a cancer therapy. So it is obviously related to biotechnology and genetic engineering, because autophagy process is regulated by the loss of genes. And discovery of those genes could help us to do genetic engineering as well as apply as a biotechnology. So autophagy scope is in food biotechnology, and to identify the protein, vastly to identify autophagy in human cells, and mechanism of cell formation, which is essential for autophagy. And finally, thank you very much. Any question regarding autophagy? Yes, please. Very nice question. Our question is, could autofagoso work without the help of lysosome? Actually, autofagosome is formed before the lysosome. When autofagosome's work is done, then it sacrifices itself to the lysosome, dumps itself to the lysosome. So autofagosome can work independently until it is unable to, you know, destroy the remaining useless material, then dump into the central garbage station lysosome. Clear? Is it clear? Okay. Do you have any other question? Please ask. Yes. Very good. Our question is whether lysosome can perform recycling process or not. Actually, lysosome is the central garbage system. When autophagosome fails to recycle the any materials which are not recyclable, then they are sent to the lysosome. So lysosome mostly an excretion process. Remove undesirable things from the cell, so that cell can survive as healthy, as powerful, so that we can act strongly. Okay? Any other question? Happy. Any question? Thank you very much for nice question. Yes.
DNA Day at BSM Aleut campus, and try
just for reading the book, but my feeling is different. Because during my student life, I was actively participated in many cultural activities, political activities, but I was always top student. So it doesn't matter. Only reading a book is not enough for your life. For your life, you need to do lots of other things. And university is the best place to make and to prepare yourself for the future challenge in your technical life. So tomorrow, I'm expecting your brilliant presentation. Do you, anyone have any questions regarding your participation or regarding your role? Any question? No question? So every group you prepare for tomorrow? Do anyone have any challenge? Who are performing, a small drama? Are anyone here? Who is performing in the stage? You. How many? Okay, very good. So what can you give us and the theme of your, tomorrow's performance? How long time it will take? How long time? 3 minutes performance. So what? I'm asking you because I have to arrange the program schedule. After the rally, is it better to perform or after the seminar? What you prefer? Just after the rally, then you perform. Then we shall start the seminar. Very good. Old auditorium. We shall do everything in the old auditorium. Do you need to clean the stage? No need to clean the stage? Because in the stage there will be chair, table and other things. Who is the team leader? Yes, please tell me what you require for tomorrow's program. No question. You want to make surprise. This is good. This is very good. And if you have any question, you can ask privately also me. And I am expecting that tomorrow you will perform nicely and show the university that you have the talents. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. And this is